Continuing on in exercise 14-4, we'll open the first floor plan. We'll zoom into the kitchen, select the camera command, pick a point in the kitchen looking towards the sink. Adjust the crop window to show more of the kitchen. You stretch this too much, it can start to get a little bit distorted. In the properties, we're going to uncheck far clip active just to make sure that we see everything beyond. We'll switch back to the floor plan. You can see the field of view has adjusted to match the adjustments we made to the crop region. With the camera selected, and if you accidentally unselected the camera, you can go down to the 3D views, and if you right click on 3D view 2, which is the one that was just created, there's an option here for show camera so that it can be selected again. Notice in properties there's an eye height and a target height that defines where the camera is relative to the floor. We can go to the sun settings for this view, click on lighting, and then make a new option called kitchen. The lighting option allows you to just enter an azimuth and altitude, which is something you might do just to get the lighting to look good. That might not be necessarily accurate for location and true north. Uncheck ground plane and then click OK. Now in our kitchen view here, I'm going to make sure the sun setting is selected to kitchen. I'm going to click on the show rendering dialog. Also noticing the sun setting is set to kitchen. We're going to set it to medium, printer quality, and a 150 DPI. We're going to set the lighting scheme to interior, sun only. There are no artificial lights in this space, so there's no point telling it to think about artificial lights. And then we'll click render. And when that's done, we can click export and call this kitchen. .jpg. Then we can close this, click save as exercise 14-4, and that completes this exercise.